that'll just run now.
I won't be stopping that. It's been a long time.
Right, pitch side when he's like.
So this is connecting to my phone. If he's struggling with it, connect to his phone. He's got better data than my phone. I'm using your internet here. I'm using my phone. If that fails, just that, you know what I mean, for you. Come on. And the internet. For you, secure it. Right, do you want to put your finger in?
Testing. Testing, testing, testing. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And oh, menu. And 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That should do nicely. Right. Right, that's common tier sorted. And this one.
That's respite, that, isn't it?
Oh no, I've just provided to the jacks up here, isn't it, sir? You got no feeding channels on?
That's just going to that, yeah. Don't matter that. This is.
You should see what the ref do.
Yeah, so I need to switch this on. Here, your microphone. HDMI, so I'm going to turn that off.
outside when it plays in that room. To do the same.
Testing, testing, testing.
Right, it's ready. Yeah.
How's that, Jamie? How's that? Is everything coming through? Everything coming through?
Warm up.
Going in this corner, I'll just go ahead and get you. just today, mate, it's heard the ball challenges and things like that. Yeah. So that when the ball's in the air, or when it's like down and stuff like that, like, I beat myself, to be on that ball, do you know what I mean? It's all about confidence to be a red sportsman.
Yeah.
There is obviously a global amount of
committees
that you're talking about
in the past goals now.
That is a thing. However, if we are on the harsher side of things, that's not ever the criticism where we are on the end.
Yeah.
So I'd rather be on the harsher side than the leading side. I will try and call anyone as I see it as well. However, if you get a conclusion, I'm all right. You can talk as much as you want to me, or with a little, just touch your
Yeah, it's a good thing.
it's going to be going off in a minute.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Actually, these have gone with.
Yeah, yeah. Just give me a thumbs up and I'll go straight into it.
What are your Cheshire rejects?
Testing.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Millennium Stadium in Featherstone, where we're here for Betfred Championship Round 5 action, the clash between Featherstone Rovers and the Widnes Vikings. So two sides coming to this clash off the back of big wins last time out, with Featherstone getting back to winning ways with a comprehensive 46-4 win over Doncaster, while Widnes overturned a half-time deficit to come out worthy winners 40-14 over Halifax Panthers. We're a few minutes away from kickoff here in a lovely sunny afternoon in West Yorkshire. The team news is in. We'll start with the home side. Featherstone making three changes to the side that were won last time out, with Ben Reynolds, Yusuf Aydin and Zach Fishwick all dropping out of the side, recalled into the side. Jaden Tanner, Leo Tennyson and Reece Butterworth, who makes his debut for Rovers this afternoon. So the Rovers line up like this. Caleb Akins is the full-back, three-quarter line of Connor Wynn, Corey Hall, Greg Minikin and Gareth Gale. Harry Bowes elevated into the starting side, partners Paul Turner in the halves. Up front for Featherstone, Gadwin Springer, Connor Jones, Jack Bussey, with Brad Day, Brad England and Danny Addy rounding off the starting side. On the bench for Rovers, Reece Butterworth, Jaden Tanner, Maurice Camano and Leo Tennyson. Wellington Albert is the 18th man. Widnes, they make two changes themselves, with Matt Fleming and Joe Edge dropping out of the side. Recalled into the lineup is Callum Field and Ollie Brooks. Widnes lineup like this, Jack Owens is the fullback, a three-quarter line of Ryan Lynch, Max Roberts, Rodri Lloyd and Mike Butt, Joe Lyon right partners there, Tom Gilmore in the halves, Liam Kirk, Jordan Johnston, Dan Murray up front, and in the back row for Widnes, Danny Langtree, Sam Wilde and Nick Gregson. On the bench, Matty Fozard, Callum Field, Ollie Brooks and Ant Walker. Kieran Dixon is the 18th man. So the stage is set for an enticing clash between two of the heavyweights of the championship. Featherstone contrasting fortunes in their opening four games. Two wins and two losses to start the season. They sit fifth in the table. Well, Widnes are joint top of the table. Second on points difference with four wins from four games from their four outings for Alan Coleman's men. And they bring some good form here to the Millennium Stadium. But this is a big test. It serves up to be for Featherstone, looking to make it two wins on the bounce and really build some momentum early in the season. A couple of off performances. The last time they were here, probably would have, by their own admission, underperformed a little bit against Bradford, but certainly back to winning ways and playing some really good style of rugby at Doncaster last week and really putting on a score. We've seen a number of different changes in the lineup over the weeks, and another change in the halves this week, obviously, with Ben Reynolds recalled by Hulkingston Rovers, gives Harry Bowes another shot in the halves. No stranger to that position so far this season. He'll once again be partnering Paul Turner, who's growing in stature with every game he plays since joining Rovers early in the season. And just waiting for the two sides to come out.
This is the better one.
And to really say, it's lovely to have a change to the downpours that we've been used to the opening 5 or 6 weeks of the season. Lovely sunny afternoon, dry conditions, perfect conditions for some free-flowing rugby league between two sides that are looking to shake things up and challenge for honours this year in the championship. And in the summer era, the bit of history between the two clubs, in the summer era, the 33 times that the clubs have met, Rovers have the edge with 24 wins to their name. The corresponding fixture here, Millennium Stadium last year, Rovers with a thumping 62-10 victory. But we're anticipating a much tougher clash this afternoon, with Widnes performing a lot better than they have done in recent seasons and been very consistent so far in the opening month of the championship. As Featherstone, led out by their skipper Danny Addy, come onto the field
The healthy crowds turned up in West Yorkshire to see this round five clash as Widnes come onto the field as well in their changed black and turquoise strip. Featherstone, of course, in their regular white and navy home strip. And from the looks of it, Featherstone will be going downhill in the first half, attacking from left to right as we see it.
I don't know.
And Widnes will be coming up the hill in the first half. Key for Featherstone here, they need to get off to a good start. Widnes, the attacking prowess they've got in their lineup. Don't need a second invitation. Strong start is what is needed by James Ford's men. We're just about ready to go here. Scott Mikulauskas, the referee, the man in the middle.
Yeah, I've got his goal.
Yeah. Oh, stage is set, we're just about ready to go here.
Anyway, mate,
so here we have it. Betfred Championship Round 5 action. Featherstone Rovers versus Widnes Vikings. You're listening live on FRTV. We'll have all of the action for you here. The ball is on the tee. Connor Wynn gets the game underway. And he's pouched safely on the try line by Gilmore. Hands it on to Kirk, who just takes the first carry of the game. Bundled backwards in a strong three-man Featherstone tackle. He's wrapped up 10 metres away from his own line. Johnston waits at acting half. Murray now. Plenty of Super League experience. Hulkingston Rovers, in his career, plays it just shy of the 20. The ball comes wide now for Lloyd. It's Wilde, I beg your pardon, who plays it just shy of that 30. Now Johnston waits at acting half. To Gilmore now, shapes, gives the ball out wide to Lyon. Out, giving it some width now to Owens. Ball out to Lloyd now, operating in the centres. Beats one, but can't get away from the attention of Galen. Desperation needed from the Featherstone winger to close down that play. Widnes have brought the ball up to the halfway line here and going to just go down just short of it with the run from Butt. Plays it. This will be the last one for Widnes. Dink down that blind side touchline. Takes one bounce, two bounces, and is cut off eventually by Aitkins. Lyon was the man who wanted to get into touch. Didn't quite go there. And Aitkins makes a bit of ground off the restart. And Gale comes forward with a second carry up and over the 40 already, Featherstone. This is a good start from the hosts. Jones waits at acting half. Into Minikin now, good early carry through the middle up and over that halfway line. Johnston, primary tackler there with help from Wilde. Comes right to Burrs, just gives the flat pass and it's dropped there by Corey Hall. A poor play and it's into the arms of Vincent. It's a double knock on there. The Featherstone just looking to get the ball wide. The pass from Burrs wasn't quite where it needed to be. Corey Hall wasn't really expecting the ball. And an early mistake from Featherstone on the halfway line gives the first advantage of the game. To Widnes, who will have a scrum about 5 metres their side of halfway. 2 minutes gone here at the Millennium Stadium. It's Featherstone 0, Widnes 0. Okay, Tom. Featherstone chancing their arm early. The poor pass off the scrum win there is eventually taken by Butt, who scrambles the best part of 2 or 3 metres up to the halfway line. Lloyd now. He's taken there by Turner. Good solid tackle underneath was Minikin. Widnes are 10 metres into Featherstone's half here. Johnston gives it to Kirk. Gregson now. Got the bumpers up, but goes down in the tackle of Bussey. 40 metres away from the line, still middle of the tackle count. Kirk comes off his left foot, trying to get the arm free. Can't do so in the tackle of Addy. Stuck to him like glue there with Springer helping out. 30 metres away from the line now, Widnes. Centre field, they come left. Gilmore turns Wilde underneath. Wilde back through the centre, meets a good solid shot there from Springer, who just stops him in his tracks and wrestles him back to the ground. 25 short of the Featherstone line. That'll be the last one for the visitors. They come left. Johnston, Gilmore dribbles it along the deck now. Aitkins cuts it off and makes it safe 10 metres out. So good defensive set there from Featherstone, who will look to clear their own line. And Gilmore looks to have taken a little bit of a knock there in back play for Widnes. Very gingerly back into the line. There's Wynn now. The settler bumps away from Gregson, who comes again and makes good ground there. Win up and over the 20-metre line. But middle of the tackle count. Featherstone going forward through Bussey, who bumps away from one and two and he's left a Widnes man on the ground. It's Johnston there who's been left wobbly-legged.
Very slow, retreating back into the line as Addy goes to that space out the back to Turner. This is good. Turner straightens up through the middle pole. Turner straightens things. He's got a man on his outside. He kicks to the corner here, looking for the Featherstone man. It's anyone's ball and it's battered dead eventually by Mike Butt. Scramble defence needed from Widnes, but great early signs there from Paul Turner. Just came off his left foot straight through the middle of the ruck. Addy recognised that there was a man down in back play and Widnes were a man short in the middle. Turner danced his way through the line, kept his poise, composure. The kick was a good one out wide, but the Widnes man just making the ball dead in front of the Featherstone chasers. But a goal line dropout coming up for Featherstone here. We've had 5 minutes of the game gone, still 0-0. As Owens, a wobbly dropout along the deck, a couple of bounces, trapped and then picked up by Gale now, who comes across field, straightens the line and goes down 30 metres out. So Featherstone with their best attacking opportunity of the game so far. Addy gives it to Springer. Springer finds his front. 25 metres out, he'll play it. Jones gives it to Addy, just straightens, no nonsense, finds the offload out back to Jones. Jones dummies, half a gap open, close on him quickly there, with Langtree making the tackle. They come left now. Turner off his left foot, looking for some honest defenders. Bush, straight flat ball, goes down 5 metres short. Desperate tackle needed by Wild. Danger not averted as Widnes come forward. Aikins now is tackled, and that's a high shot. Creeping up over the shoulders was Langtree there, and this will be a penalty to Featherstone, and another set of six coming up for the home side here. This is just a start that James Ford would have wanted, playing with plenty of tempo, plenty of energy, asking questions with the ball. Jones taps it, and Addy finds Springer. Springer just accelerates into the line, such a hard man to stop. Gadwin Springer, he goes down a metre short, bang in front of the post. Plenty of tackles in the bag for Featherstone. What have they got? Bose, first receiver, flat pass for England. The Widnes defence was alert to it. Wild chief tackler there. Helped out by Murray. They come forward. Addy shapes, double pumps, gives it to Aikins. Aikins flat pass there to Day. Day, going to be hard to stop here, and he's brought down half a metre short. Langtree again all up, creeping a little bit high there. Penalty not given. Bussey now just fakes to give it, gives it out the back now. There's a little bit of space. Bose finds England. He's coming back against the grain. He eventually goes down in the Widnes tackle. Kirk was the man. Flat pass for Bussey. Bussey's going to go close here. He's a half a blade of grass short and plays it just to the left of the post. Addy, last tackle for Featherstone. Dinks the ball into the in-goal area. Addy, far too much on it. And it goes over the dead ball line, and that'll be a seven tackle set. So for all that promise, Featherstone couldn't quite pull the right rein with the ball in hand there. And not the best end of set as Widnes look to clear their line. Butt is the man who takes the first carry. And he's rounded up 30 metres away from his own line, centre field. Gilmore finds Ince. Ince grassed in a good tackle there by Bose and Jones. They come forward again here. It's Roberts now, plays it five short of halfway. Widnes come forward again through Murray, up and over the halfway line. That'll only be the third tackle for Widnes. Johnston seems to have shaken off that earlier knock. Kirk is the man who runs into the tackle of England. Over the top was Bose. Widnes all of a sudden 40 metres away from the Featherstone line here. Gregson just takes it himself here and up to the 30. That'll be the last one for Widnes. 30 metres away from the line, centre field. They come left. Gilmore does the honours with the kicking. High kick through the centre of the field. Taken, no pressure there by Aikins, but he's immediately enveloped to the tackle of Johnston. And Featherstone now look to clear their own line. Real set for set, end-to-end action so far as Corey Hall finds a half gap, goes down 30 out from his own line. 8 minutes gone here at the Millennium Stadium. Featherstone 0, Widnes 0. Listening live on FRTV as Wynn shrugs away from 1-2, eventually goes down in the tackle of Murray. Langtree in there as well as Bussey. Been busy early, Jack Bussey. Made his return from injury last week. Starts again this afternoon. And he's put on his back 2 metres into Widnes territory, middle of the tackle count. Jones at acting half. Fires the ball out to Addy. Addy to Turner. Turner, dummies. Fires a lovely pass here for Minikin. He releases Aikins out wide. They must score here, Featherstone. If he gives the ball to Gale, and Gale touches down in the corner. A fantastic piece of play from Featherstone Rovers. That's been coming for a few minutes. Featherstone easily making the better start, plenty of energy. Again, it was Paul Turner who just got the ball early from Addy, double pumped it, found the space, gave it to Minikin, who split the field, and he summed it up nicely, gave the ball out wide in the end to Gaz Gale, who touched down acrobatically in the corner for his 10th try of the season, and more importantly gives Featherstone Rovers the early advantage they were looking for. We've had 9 minutes gone here at the Millennium Stadium. It's Featherstone 4, Widnes 0.
How you doing, mate? You okay over there?
Yeah, no worries.
We've already seen in just the opening 10 minutes of here, Paul Turner really finding his feet at half-back there for Featherstone. The couple of touches he's had have been very classy. A line break with the first touch coming back off his left foot, and then the line break assist there to put Minikin away. Fantastic play from the Australian. Then once Minikin was in the clear, he just summed it up well. Had options with Aikins on his inside, Gale on his outside, gave it to the big winger, who just dived in over the corner flag to score out wide. And a fantastic start for Featherstone here. Danny Addy doing the kicking duties. Louis Gorman, of course, not featuring this afternoon, so Addy, the difficult one, a couple of metres in from the left touchline, steps up, strikes it, and it's waved away by the touch judges. So the score remains Featherstone Rovers 4, Widnes Vikings 0.
We do? Yeah, right. My apologies. Always, mate.
Back up to the halfway line is Owens, will be the man kicking off now for Widnes.
I know it's picky, but just pull it to the side if you need to slightly.
And really, really good signs from Featherstone. A lot to like for James Ford and the Featherstone faithful. As the kickoff comes, a couple of bounces. Bit of a difficult one for Bose, who cuts it off and gives it on to Bussey now. Bussey just winds up and goes down 15 away from his own line, centre of the field, on the first tackle. Springing out, back through the ruck. Good carry from the big Frenchman. And a quick play of the ball as well. Gives it to Addy now. Addy through the middle. A little bit of late footwork from Addy. And up and over the 40 now. Featherstone just three tackles. Turner drops off Day this time. Day almost slipped the net there. But a good tackle down low from Langtree. Halted his progress. Jones off the quick play. Pinches 10 metres. Tripped up and eventually put on the ground there. Just as well from a Widnes perspective. That'll be the last one. 45 away from the Widnes line. Turner doing the kicking this time. Just puts the ball in the air. Testing one taken by Butt. Didn't have a lot of pressure on him. But a good kick chase there from England. Rounds him up 15 metres away from his line. But there's a bit of a problem in back play here for Springer, who looking very, very uncomfortable as he comes from the field here. And James Ford having to go to his bench early here. Jaden Tanner is the man injected into the action, perhaps a little bit earlier than they would have hoped. We'll keep an eye on whether Springer can come back onto the field as Tanner straight into the action wraps up his opposite number, Murray. And Widnes with Langtree up and over the 40, finds the offload for Johnston. Johnston gives it to Kirk. Kirk stands in a three-man Featherstone tackle. To ball and all by Bussey and Jones. This will be the last one. Widnes kicking from halfway. Gilmore puts it along along through the air, taken on the full by Wynn, and Wynn has a little bit of room to move now and returns it with a bit of interest. He'll go down 30 metres away from his own line. 13 minutes of the game gone here. Featherstone leading Widnes by 4 points to nil. That early Gareth Gale try. The difference between the sides so far. Minikin played a prominent role in that try, up to the halfway line now with his carry. Jones scampers out of acting half, nearly knocked off his feet by Gregson. The fans looking for an offside penalty not given by the referee. But Featherstone 40 metres away from the Widnes line. Addy finds Tanner now. Tanner, no nonsense, tucks the ball under his wing and pinches the best part of 6 metres after contact. This will be the last one. 30 metres out, Turner's going to kick again, goes to the skies again. A little bit of pressure on Butt this time, but gets off the ground, takes it well, but he's immediately swallowed up. The great kick chase from Day.
puts him on the ground 5 metres away from his own line. Lloyd Day back into the action, puts him down 10 metres out. This is good from Featherstone, attacking with their defence. Owen, so that's Ince. Ince is put to ground there. And a solid tackle from Hall and Burrs. Still inside their own 20. They go out of that red zone now. Through Max Roberts. Come forward through Murray. Featherstone have done a good job containing Widnes here so far in this set. That'll be the last one. Kicking from their own 30 now, Widnes. Owens under a little bit of pressure. It's a good kick. Puts it back through the middle of the ruck. And it's cut off on the 10-metre line by Connor Wynn. Wynn tries to go on the outside of Roberts. Almost gets round Roberts, but just gets hold of the shirt collar. Puts him on the ground. Good early signs from Connor Wynn. Been very busy so far. England. That's a huge shot from Johnston there, who just knocks England off his feet. And England did well to regroup. Gets up smiling. As Hall is given a similar treatment now by the Widnes defence. Plays the ball on his own 40. A couple of tackles still to come for Featherstone. Tanner now. He's tried to offload the ball and it's picked up by Lyon now. So a soft error perhaps there for Featherstone. Just gives Widnes a leg up. They've got the ball 5 metres into Featherstone territory. And Lloyd now. Through the middle of the ruck. Murray. Straightens things up. He's taken to ground. 35 metres away from the Featherstone line, middle of the field. Tanner the man tackling with Bussey. Johnston gives it to Gilmore. Gilmore out the back to Owens. Owens straightens into the line. Roberts is wrapped up in a good ball and all tackle off the wing. Came Connor Wynn to shut that play down. Widnes are 20 metres away from the line. This is arguably the best territory they've had in the game so far. Wild. That's the kick to Gregson. Gregson looked to get the arm free. Untidy offload taken. One bounce by Johnston. Johnston through the middle of the ruck. He's just pulled to ground there by a desperate tackle from England. And now the penalty conceded by Harry Bowes. A second effort. There's very little complaint Featherstone could have on that one. This will be a penalty. Gilmore now deciding what to do. This will be, you'd imagine, a tap restart. And it's taken now by Kirk. Kirk wrapped up just to the right-hand side of the post. Quick play of the ball. The Johnston. Out to Langtree. Langtree just looking for an option on the inside. Door is closed firmly by Tanner. All hands to the pumps defensively for Featherstone. Ball comes out to Lyon. Gives it out to Gilmore. Gilmore out to Roberts. One-on-one with Hall. Hall sticks to him well. Finds the offload for Owens. But a smothering tackle on the inside. Three Featherstone jerseys in there. And he eventually finds the offload for Ince now. Wild has the ball. Widnes have somehow kept this ball alive and advanced it right up until the try line. Just to the left-hand side of the purse. But Featherstone, desperation in defence. Gregson juggles it, gives it to Lyon. Lyon, looping pass over the top by Lloyd, is knocked on. Surely that's a knock-on. And it's given eventually by the referee. And high fives all around for Featherstone. A huge green tick from James Ford. The defence on their own line, superb. Featherstone, Widnes had them stretched on the left before coming all the way back to the right.
It's a scrum in the middle.
And Featherstone turned up on every occasion to close down the danger there. And the turnover from the knock-on. The pass over the top from Lyon was a good one. Lyons was a good one. But Lloyd just fumbling it as he tried to bring it in. And the danger averted for now for Featherstone. Still leading by 4 points to nil as we approach the 18-minute mark here at the Millennium Stadium. Scrum feed is won. Hall off the left foot. Looks good on his feet, Corey Hall. Takes the tackle 20 metres away from his own line on the first. Minikin, a little bit of footwork. Up to the 30 now. Good play, quick play of the ball for Jones. Is it to Turner? Turner keeps hold of it, did the right thing. There's pressure on him. Jones away again. This is what he likes, a quick ruck. On to Aikens, punching holes here, Featherstone, with every play up to the halfway line. Jones an acting half. Comes back through the middle of the field, Addy. Just up, just short of the 40 metre line. Widnes a side of halfway on the last. suppose, is going to do the kicking this time. Taking a little bit of a charge down there, and it's knocked on by Paul Turner. And that's a good result for Widnes, and arguably one that they're fortunate to get. The kick from Burrs, he was a little bit slow in getting that kick away. It was partially charged down by Gregson. It went into the air. Turner had taken that, it was back to one. Turner just fumbling the ball there.
It's a scrum, mate. Yeah, it is.
First real thing that Turner's done wrong is
shot for corner, it's going to be a scrum instead.
Taking the scrum here.
Referee
eventually signalling a scrum. I thought we were going to have a play of the ball, but the referee saying, nope, scrum head and feed to Widnes, which will be on their own 40.
Let's get in now. Joe, shot clock's on. Get in. Okay, shot clock off.
Scrum feed is won by Widnes. They come through forward through Roberts. Good grassing tackle there by Burrs. Chops him down. Owens gives it to Wild. He's wrapped up by England. 10 metres into Featherstone territory now. Our Widnes, Gilmore drops off Murray. Good, uncompromising defence there from Addy. Up and under the ball. Helped out by Tanner. Put Murray on his back. 40 metres out. Johnston through the middle of the ruck. With Featherstone almost caught the Featherstone defence napping, but they did enough. Aikins came into the line, regrouped, and hauled him to ground. 25 out. Still tackles remaining for the visitors. Gilmore, first receiver. Ball over the top into the in-goal area here. It gets a lovely bounce as Aikins has a little bit of room. He's going to try and get out of play here, but he's rounded up and put to ground in the in-goal, so that'll be a goal line dropout. And the first bit of back-to-back sets that Widnes have been able to force. It was a good kick from Gilmore, just dinked it in behind the Featherstone line. The ball sat up on its point. Aikins took it well, but there was a wall of Widnes defenders there to make sure that he didn't escape the in goal. And another set of six coming up for the Vikings. Dropout is taken by Burrs. Taken on the bounce by Lyons. Gives it on now to Kirk. Kirk, good tackle there by Tanner. Just puts him to ground 30 metres away from the Featherstone line. Gregson gives it to Murray. Murray. Good tackle over the top there by Bussey. 30 metres out now, Widnes. And the second tackle, Johnston. Is it out to Gilmore? Gilmore out to Lyons. Lyons drops off Langtree. Langtree taken to ground there. Good tackle by Jones and Day. 20 metres out now, Widnes. Centre field, Gregson gives the ball out to Gilmore. Gilmore flat pass for Wild. Wild cut down there, and a great tackle by Harry Burrs. Johnston scampers out to me half again, gives it to Murray. Murray is cut down, five short of the try line, just to the left hand side of the post. This will be the last one for the visitors. Gilmore under pressure, out the back to Owens. Owens juggled it, put the kick into the in goal area, beats everybody over the dead ball line, and that'll be a seven tackle set coming up for Featherstone. More great defence from the hosts on their own try line. You could see the pressure they put Gilmore under there. He had to hurry the pass to Owens. Owens nearly went without it, manufactured a kick, but the kick was a poor one and beat everybody over the dead ball line. And Featherstone take over possession now on the 30 metre line through Minikin. Hall plays it on the 40. Bowes out of acting half, best part of 8 or 9 metres there for the halfback. Plays it on halfway. Bussey route one through the ruck, beats one, almost beats a second. This is good from Featherstone. 35 metres away from the Widnes line. Jones, shape right, shape left, went right. Hall has it. Trying to go around Gilmore. Gilmore flicks pass, lovely flick pass from Wynn. Wynn skips away from 1-2, he's into space. He's looking to find the last pass, he can't quite do so. The ball stripped out by the Widnes man. That'll be a penalty. And Featherstone will have another set of six coming up here, 10 metres away from the Widnes line. Great play from Corey Hall, just manufactured that pass. The flick pass out the back was wonderful, gave Wynn the space. He bumped away from one, cut back in field. He was eventually rounded up. We had the ball taken from his grasp as Featherstone start the set again. Tanner, off the tap restart, plays it 5 metres out, just to the left-hand side of the uprights. Jones dummies it, goes himself. Door closes on him. He'll play it. Addy has the pass for Aikins. Aikins slipped the net, tries to go again, Aikins, but eventually brought down. The initial effort from Langtree was just enough. Danger not averted though, as Featherstone come forward again. Tanner stands in the tackle this time. Three witness defenders around him. Plays the ball, or will play the ball eventually, 8 metres out. Just to the left of the post, they come back centre field. Turner, looping pass out to England. England's going to score untouched! And wonderful play again from Paul Turner. Manufactures Featherstone's second try of the game. It was a lovely pass. He had three options, and he picked the right one once again, Turner. England ran into the space, took it just above his head, and that was enough to fool the witness defenders, and the big back rower strolls in untouched. And after 25 minutes of this contest at the Millennium Stadium, Featherstone double their advantage. They now lead Widnes Vikings by 8-0. He may just have one error to his name so far this afternoon, but Paul Turner having a real day out, a really good first half so far, causing problems with the witness defence whenever he touches the ball. Supplied the break for the first try to Gareth Gale, and this time a sublime pass between two witness defenders just put Brad England over untouched. About 10 metres to the right hand side of the post, and Danny Addy now with a slightly easier conversion attempt. Has the opportunity to give it a
20. Cheers. Double digit lead here for Featherstone. Steadies himself, Addy.
Here comes Tom.
Wait.
Strikes it well and drives it between the posts. It's now Featherstone over 10 with the Vikings near. Featherstone getting their rewards for playing direct, playing with energy, they've charged down the hill there after that.
Oh, we're looking for time, Steve. Is there a clock? No, there about.
There's 15 left.
Is it? Thank you. Cheers.
Yeah, it is, yeah. Well, slightly out, 15 left.
15 left, sorry, mate. 15 left, that clock's quick. That clock's quick, 15 minutes left.
All on, when you're ready, mate.
Came up past the ball, he found the right arm. And Featherstone have a 10-point advantage. As the kickoff comes, taken and given to Maurice Camano now, who's just come onto the field.
One! Move now! Hands up!
Hold! The afternoon plays on his own 20. England the try scorer.
Two! Roger! Hold!
Plays it 25 out. Addy. To Tanner. Tanner's been very busy.
Three! Matty!
Really for the injured Godwin Spring.
Three, thank you. Well done, Sam.
They come forward again now. Addy, lovely pass there for Day. Day's wrapped up in a good ball and all tackle. It has to be said from
the release now!
Four.
Up to the halfway line now and over it. Addy straightens things up. This
five,
time.
Matty!
Back 40 metres away from the witness line. This will be the last one.
Five.
Come left through Turner. Put the ball along the deck this time on that foul. Left touchline side, cut off. 5 metres from his line by Owens.
One! Move now! Come on, make it back! No, go on.
And Widnes start 10 metres away from their line. But.
Hold your middle, Scott.
Yeah. Two! Move now! Hold in the middle, Brad! Hold!
Stick of Featherstone's defence. Aggressive, no nonsense stuff so far in this game as Ince tries
Brad!
Put to ground. 25 Fozard now on the field for the visitors. Hands it off to Roberts.
Four! High off the ball! Hands off!
Roberts will play it 40 out.
Go four.
Middle of the tackle count for the Vikings.
Five! Move! This
will be the last one, in fact. Field plays it. And Gilmore puts the kick.
Give 10 here, Sam.
Field again. Just looking to dissect.
Thank you.
Back and winger, and the 20. Ball eventually goes over 20. The dead ball line once
last
again.
Last man, who's our last man?
Widnes. Wait, Addy.
Two sets of six.
Wait. Good to go.
Losing the radar a little bit with the kick.
Zero! Matty! Callum!
And Featherstone with a second tackle set.
Don't play for it. Zero.
Minikin now.
One! Get it! Go on.
Buzz scampers out of dummy half, finds the pass for Day up and over halfway.
Two!
Once again,
Mike!
Mike Allen, square!
2 metres with the ball.
Go two.
In this first half. Boats drops off Kamano. Kamano into the centre field. Tackle from Brookson.
Three! Son!
Brookson there to help.
Goal three.
Forward again, out the back. Aikens gives it to Hall. Hall stands. Beats
one. Go three.
Under the footwork, Aikens beats. His man.
Four! Move now, Sam! Come on, fellas!
The tackle of Brooks.
He's trapped. Four. Brooks. Tangled there. Both batted each other. Four.
Well, Turner finds Tanner.
Tanner five! Callum! Almost Callum!
By the witness defence. This will be the last one. Featherstone are 20 metres out centre field. They come right. Buzz doing the kick.
He's okay, they're all tied.
A little bit of pressure here. Ball taken cleanly by Ince. And it's a penalty against.
He's in the air for one. Malicious in that play. And he's landed dead. He's in the air for one and he's landed dangerously, mate. Okay, so it's just a penalty, nothing. He's landed dangerously, mate.
His feet in taking that ball. He did take it cleanly. Incidentally, the witness man, but the penalty goes against.
It's back here, though. Are you tapping it or? Oh, it's there.
And the relieving penalty is for the visitors. So we hit the half an hour mark here at the Millennium Stadium. It remains Featherstone Rovers 10. Vikings.
No. Let's say it right.
Gilmore going to have the kick to touch here.
Halfway shot.
Halfway, boys.
25 metres away from his own line, so witness.
Oh.
Start the set. Lyons finds Brooks now.
Right, here, here. What? Move now, Connor!
Tackle from Tanner.
Boys.
Jones.
Go on.
In there as well. Gregson. Bloody Bears.
Release now!
Two. Opposite number Andy. 35 metres away from their own line. Brooks gives it out wide to Gilmore. Gilmore flat pass for Wild.
Three! Move, Corey! Red, yes, please!
Halfway. Fozzard waits for that
goal. Go three.
Gives it on to Field. Field. Straightens things up.
Four! Corey!
By Addy.
Wait.
Couple of metres into Featherstone territory here. Fozzard out of dummy half gives it to Brooks. Brooks is bent backwards in the tackle of Day and Tanner.
Five! Move now! Make the last!
This will be the last one for witness. 35 metres out, Lyons.
Callum, you're off, mate.
This will be a difficult one for Gail. Gail takes it.
So zero! Zero! Correct!
Langtree,
zero! And just move now!
The space had opened zero. Up in front of the big winger. And he kept hold of it and came back
in field. Get to Fozzard in the middle.
One! Move, Matty! Come on, mate! Go on, that's fine.
For Hall, straight through the middle of the ruck, Corey Hall. Finds the pass for Day. Day up
two.
In the halfway.
Two! Find the space! Find the ground!
Go two. He's currently defending a man light. Turner gives it to Burrs. Burrs, no options, just takes it himself. Hands it on now to Tennyson, who's just come on the field now.
Three! No, Tanner. It's a shoulder injury.
Tennyson
goal
plays
three.
It halfway. Jones, shapes right, comes left, gives it to Turner.
And he's behind play.
Turner gives it to Day.
Zero!
A good one, and it's lost by Day. Picked up by Lyons, and Lyons salvages possession for witness as we're going to have a stoppage in play here. It's Nick Gregson, the man left on the ground by
for
witness. In all sorts of trouble.
It, so
some sort of shoulder or arm injuries in the arms of the physio at the moment, about 25 metres away from the play.
I don't know why, and I'd probably be asking the same as you, mate, if I was in your shoes, but.
So we'll just stop to take a breather here.
It's clearly hurt his arm.
8 minutes to go until.
So that was zero I've got.
Featherstone at 10, witness Vikings.
Just keep that mark, and it's lying. It's lying right in the ball.
Tries with one conversion.
Zero tackle there, witness ball.
Has Featherstone in a strong position heading into half-time here.
I'm going to say it's not that over here.
Brookson back on his feet. He's not going to be okay to carry on here. He's going to have to come through the field, his arm in a makeshift sling using his shirt. You can only assume that's some form
play
of
the ball,
shoulder
to play
or peck injury.
Not yet, though.
I hope it's nothing too serious, but you'd imagine he's long odds to play any further part in this game.
That was zero, so next one will be one. Yeah, mate, I'm all right. Hold on a minute.
Let's make the change.
Wait till we're clear.
It's Ant Walker who's on the field. For Gregson, it looks very
take
forlorn.
A step. Go.
From the field.
Go. Just take a step back so you play on the mark for me, please. Nice and tight, Greg.
Looks very uncomfortable indeed.
Good to go, Scott.
Has been very busy in the middle of the field for Widnes as the game restarts. Lloyd now. To just short of the halfway line.
Brad! Go on.
Fozzard. Walker, who gets his first taste of
action. No! Come on!
Compromisingly thrown to the ground by Kamano. 5 metres. Featherston side of halfway. Gilmore, flat pass for Wild. Wild, good tackle. Off his edge there from Corey Hall.
Go three.
Goodness. 30 metres away from the line. Brooks.
Four! Danny!
Plays it. 30 out go now, centre of the field. Fozzard gives it out wide to Lyons. Lyons, flat pass for Langtree. Langtree. Right, Day plays it quickly. This will be the last one. Fozzard gives it to Lyons.
Okay. Back
in the middle, taken by Addy, and gives the ball on to Aikins. Great play. Isaac play from the Pelican captain.
Go on, good.
And Featherston, tough job to get away from their own line. Here now is Gales pulling
no
his back.
Penalties.
10
wait.
Metres out. So already the second tackle. Minikin makes a couple of metres forward here, but we're just doing a good job.
Hold! Go three.
To limit Featherston's go forward is Wynn. Tries to get the ball looking over
four.
The 20 and
Max.
Does so, but
get
limited yards
on
offer here for the home side in this set. Aikins. No forwards carrying the ball
Mike.
In this set, but Aikins
five,
with a huge
eight,
carry. Best
Max.
Part of 15 metres upfield.
Yeah,
advances
five.
The ball 40 out, and Jones is
outside.
Going to kick on the left.
Well,
just drills it along the deck.
Yep.
It's a good one, right through the middle of the ruck. Taken by Ince on his own 10-metre line. What's the chase like? It's not a bad one. As they wrap up, Ryan Ince, 20 metres away from his own line. A good exit set in the end, manufactured by Featherston.
Don't
that'll
push,
please
Brad.
Coach James Ford. As Roberts.
All the way back. Two.
Roberts.
Go.
Plays
two.
It 25 out. But they're busy in off his left wing.
Move!
He's wrapped up there by Tennyson.
No.
His
you're holding him in, Mike.
There.
You're holding him in,
waving.
Mike. Three.
Get up.
You're not getting them, mate.
Milking the play as Owens.
Four.
Taken
Connor,
down
Connor.
There by England and Jones. Witness 10 metres their side of halfway as the offload comes out of the tackle there from Walker to Fozzard.
No,
did a good job
five.
To halt his go. Progress there. This will be the last one. Witness kicking from 40 metres out.
He's okay.
The kick from Gilmore again. Aikins takes
down.
It comfortably and he's
go
put
minute.
On the ground there by Field.
Stand! Go one.
It's Gale. Drags a couple of Widnes defenders forward, but he's actually bent back.
Go.
Onto his back, 20 metres out. Inside the final 5 minutes of this first
three.
Half, Featherston still
Ant.
Leading Widnes by 10 points to nil. As Minikin almost went through the line, plays it now for Hall. Hall, back through the middle.
Four, Sam!
Wrapped up by Brooks.
Yeah, mate.
40 metres out now, Featherston in their own half. Kamano takes the ball from Addy. Just
five,
goes up to
seven,
the halfway man. Line. Good note. Solid carry from Kamano. This will be the last one. Bo's going to do the kicking again here.
You're off!
Into the air once
he
again. A lot of high kicks coming down the field
you.
At the moment. Owens
yeah,
takes it
now,
with nobody
now,
really around him. And just drops it off the butt now. And butt is put to ground.
Move now, Brad! Get out! Get out!
20 minutes out to Featherston. Just content to go through their sets. Challenge Widnes to come up the other end of the field. They've built a handy lead heading to half time.
No!
And a bit solid defensively.
Got two.
As Langtree nearly went without it. Keeps hold of it and
three!
Is tackled
move!
In the end by Tennyson.
Oh dear.
Tennyson just working the line over and has lost the ball there, but the penalty given against Tennyson. Protests his
mate.
Innocence.
It's borderline.
And a little
it's
bit of ill discipline from Featherston just creeping in there. He's late in the tackle count there. There's no need for the second effort on the ball. Quite often penalised in those situations.
Really?
Witness now with a penalty kick to touch on that far side will start their set 5 metres into Featherston's half. On just the first tackle as Walker takes it in centre field. Cries for a forward pass, not given. Fozzard, shaped to go left, comes right in the end. Through the middle of the ruck. But not before he's made the best part 20 metres upfield. 30 metres away
two.
From the Featherston line now. Brooks. Into the line, flat pass for Walker. Walker
three.
Put to ground there.
Blood.
Underneath
hold.
Was England.
Hold.
20 metres out. Options left and right. They come left. Gilmore. Flat pass there for Roberts. Roberts is going to score on the left edge here. And in the shadows of half-time, the penalty that Featherstone conceded just a few moments ago is punished in the worst way possible, as Gilmore just hit the flat pass. A lovely cut-out ball, in fact. To Max Roberts, who just hit it at pace, skimmed on the outside of his man. There was nothing Aitkins could do to prevent him from scoring in the left corner, about 5 metres in from the left touchline. And Widnes have their first points of the game. It's now Featherstone Rovers 10, Widnes Vikings 4.
How long's resty?
About 3.5.
About three and a half minutes, Tom. Cheers, mate. Yeah, that's carried on no matter what stops we've had.
The decision making for
just a disappointing end to the half here for Featherstone, who've done everything right so far in this game.
Cheers, mate. Just focus the last 3 minutes.
Just give Widnes an opportunity. Penalty 40 metres away from the line, late in the tackle count, gave Widnes the field position. And they were duly obliged in taking advantage there. Gilmore just laying on a plate for Max Roberts. And Gilmore now, 10 metres in from the left touchline, has the opportunity to convert the try, which he does so, and cuts the gap to 4 here in the shadows of half-time. It's Featherstone Rovers 10, Widnes Vikings 6. So here we are then, game on, 4-point game. Late in the first half at the Millennium Stadium, listening live on FRTV. Featherstone Rovers 10, Widnes Vikings 6.
Now
Featherstone will be looking to respond after the disappointment of conceding that first try so late in the piece here. As Wynn dabs the ball down, it's taken by Lyons on the try line, given to Walker. Walker with a big collision there with Kamano. To ground, 12 metres away from his line on the first tackle. Lloyd, Welsh international, he's dribbling around forever. Reggie Lloyd, still
release now.
Playing up to a good standard, operating in the right centre this afternoon. As Widnes make the mistake, Langtree pushing the pass. Zero. It was a poor one, and it was spilt by Mike Button. Featherstone now, with very little time left on the clock, have a set of six perhaps to try and re-establish their lead. Addy gives it to Kamano. Kamano's met front on by Brooks. Goes again, Kamano makes another metre after contact. 30 metres out, tackles in the bank here. Addy, it's a ball to Tennyson. Tennyson stands in the tackle. There's a trio of black jerseys around him. Wild and Field.
Six again
given against Widnes here. Hand on the ball. Ball comes out the back to Aitkins. Aitkins chip over the top, looking for Hall. Corey Hall's going to collect it and score. Rounds it underneath the post. And what a try and what a response off the back of Widnes getting their first try. The six again had been called. It came off the back of a mistake from Widnes. Lovely play out the back, gave Caelan Aitkins the space, and he just chipped it in behind the line. It was a perfectly weighted kick. He knew that Jack Owens wasn't in position. It was taken on the full by Corey Hall, who just rounded the last man and improved the angle to score underneath the post. And Featherstone firmly back in control of this game as the half-time siren approaches. It's now Featherstone Rovers 14, Widnes Vikings 6.
All right, yeah, of course we are. Okay.
What a bit of brilliance there as the siren sounds. This will be the last act of the first half. Wonderful piece of play from Caleb Aitkins. We've spoken this afternoon about how good some of Paul Turner's play's been this afternoon, but don't forget about Aitkins, always safe at the back in defence and supplying the quality with ball in hand. You thought that there was an opportunity to go through the hands there. He just summed it up brilliantly. The chip over the top was absolutely perfect. Corey Hall took it. Scores underneath the post, an easy conversion for captain Danny Addy, pilots it between the posts and brings the half-time score now to Featherstone Rovers 16, Widnes Vikings 6. Featherstone started the half well with a try to Gaz Gale from long range just 10 minutes into the game, for Brad England scored on the 25-minute mark. A lovely play from Paul Turner on both occasions to set up a 10-0 lead. And Widnes few minutes out from half time, got on the scoreboard themselves with a much needed Max Roberts try from their point of view, which was converted. And then just the last act of the first half, Corey Hall scoring a brilliant try from the Caleb Aitken's kick, converted by Danny Addy. Gives a scoreline, I believe, Featherston fully deserved. It's half time here at the Millennium Stadium. It's Featherston 16, Widnes Vikings 6. We'll take a quick break and be back for all the second half action in a few minutes' time.
Just come in a sec, just ask you about it.
In terms of this, who manages this?
Because, obviously, that ball's more about the weight to go. And so it's easy, someone could just walk in to have a tip. Do you know what I mean? I know I expect someone to be stuck there all the time, but at the same time, I feel. I'm not saying anything's gone or anything like that. I was thinking about it pre-game, and obviously I didn't have anyone to speak to, it's just I've took that opportunity now. I know we're in a difficult, it's not as straightforward as that or anything like that. It was just a question, that was all. Yeah. Well, take our packs off and just bang them back in just so we
loss of network.
Thank you.
Hello and welcome back to the Millennium Stadium in Featherstone, where we're here for the second half action of this Betfred Championship Round 5 clash between Featherstone Rovers and the Widnes Vikings. Featherstone taking a 16-6 lead into the half-time break, and both sides are back on the field and the game is underway. Featherstone attacking from right to left up the hill as we see it in the second half, and Connor Wynn pouches the kickoff safely and takes it, the tackle 10 metres away from his own line. Kamano now straight into the action off the restart. Featherstone deserved of their 10-point lead. Three tries in the first half as they give it some width now. Aikens gives it on to Minikin. Minikin tries to go around his man. A little bit of space in the offering. Lyons comes again to halt his progress. 35 metres away from his own line. Gale, first try scorer in the game, just crabs across field. Backs his way the best part of 5 or 6 metres up to the halfway line or just short of it. Jones misses Tennyson, gives it to Addy. Addy comes off his left foot and goes down 8 metres into Widnes territory. Not a bad opening set from Rovers. The last tackle, Bowes is doing the kicking once again. Puts it high. A tester for Ince takes it well. He's lost the ball in contact there. It's picked up by England and this has got to be a set restart and a perfect start here for Featherstone. The error from Ince under pressure from Corey Hall. The kick was a good one. And Featherstone with an opportunity to build on this now as Langtree comes in to cut down Tennyson. A good strong shot from the Widnes man. Kamano takes the ball from Addy, straightens things up and goes down 5 metres short of the line here, just to the right-hand side of the posts. Jones waits an acting half, gives it to Bowes. Bowes double pumps, gives it to Aikens. Aikens into the line here, just has to submit to the tackle there. The Featherstone lead man just getting in the way of things. He'll play it 10 metres to the left of the post. Short ball here for Day. He's going to try back his way to the line. Brad Day, has he scored? He's reached the line. The referee points to the spot. And a wonderful start turns into a perfect start for Featherstone Rovers, who get their first try of the second half. Just 2 minutes into the action here. A wonderful piece of play. Short ball there from Connor Jones. Just hit Brad Day at pace. He turned, he hit and spun. Took three defenders over the line with him. Gets the ball down for Featherstone's first try of the second half and their fourth try of the afternoon as Featherstone take a firm grip on this game. It's Featherstone 20, Widnes Vikings 6. There's the craft and the guile there of Connor Jones. Spotted that the Widnes defenders had come up quickly on that edge. A couple of them had come up past the ball, managed to isolate a defender. Brad Day hit it. The Widnes got numbers into the tackle, but the strength of Brad Day wasn't to be denied. He turned away from the defence, forced the ball down on the whitewash. And a crucial, crucial try coming off the back of a Widnes error. How many times do we see it? Mistakes in your own half, often punished, and Featherstone this time, more often than not, have been good enough to take advantage of the opportunities given to them by Widnes. And a sizeable 14-point lead for the home side early in this second half. Danny Addy from about 15 metres in from the left touchline, 22 metres out, has the opportunities, 2 from 3 so far this afternoon. Very much a Mr. Fix-It, Danny Addy. Can turn his hand to any position and any duty in the team as he guides the ball between the posts once again. And that brings the scoreline now to Featherstone Rovers 22, Widnes Vikings 6. Wonderful piece of play from Connor Jones. All of the pivots playing their part so far in what's been a strong performance from Featherstone. Made very good starts to both halves here. Widnes now staring down the barrel of a 16-point deficit. The game is back underway. Kamano takes the ball from Aitkins, just careers back into the defence. Callum Field, I believe, once spent some, whether a loan or dual registration spell with Featherstone. Now in the colours of Widnes as Fozard comes to meet Wynn, whose strong ball carrier Connor Wynn refuses to go down, eventually does so 30 out from his line. Jones to Gale. Gale just taken and thrown to the ground by Langtree. Looked
to the 40. Turner just hands it off to Addy this time. Gives it to England. England stopped in the tackle. A bit of a cry for a high shot there on England. A little bit of a crusher tackle as well, I think, there. But just a by accident. There's nothing malicious in that tackle at all. Just the way that England fell into the tackle. He's not happy about the attention he was given there. His physio comes to check him. The referee's not interested in escalating things any further than just to play the ball here, I don't think. In fact, I'm completely wrong. He blows the penalty as Brooks, the man penalised for a crusher tackle. He just shakes his head, wonders what on earth the referee's found that call from, but it must have been a call from the touch judge there, as originally the referee was happy to wave play on. But the tap is taken by Bowes, gives the flat pass for England, who's thankfully okay. And he's driven backwards, eventually finds the pass for Hall. Hall's got a little bit of room to move now. Corey Hall gets the ball free, almost got the ball free, and he's wrapped up, put down by Ince. Desperate tackle from the Widnes winger. Featherstone, 30 metres away from the Widnes line. Bowes gives it to Addy, flat pass for Tennyson. Tennyson shapes, finds a little bit of space. Good low tackle there from Fozard. 20 metres out, Jones gives it to Turner. Turner, flat pass there for Day, most recent try scorer. Looking for his second, he goes down 5 metres short, 10 metres to the left-hand side of the post. Comes back centre field for Turner, shapes, drops off Tennyson now. Tennyson through the middle of the ruck. Tackled by three Widnes defenders there. He's banging in front of the post, 10 metres out. Options left and right, they go right. Buzz, flat pass for Kamano. Kamano just takes the tackle, a settling play there to bring up the last for Featherstone. They come right again. Bowes off his right foot, looking for a try, and the door's closed on him on the inside. So good defensive set, it has to be said, from Widnes there. But Featherstone not asking too many questions with ball in hand there, just content to make Widnes do a bit of defending down their own end, and will now challenge them to go upfield. We have 7 minutes gone here in the second half of the Millennium Stadium. Featherstone 22, Widnes 6. 4 tries to 1 so far, and 4 different try scorers. Brad Day getting his 6th of the season. And incidentally, actually, Corey Hall in the first half getting his first try in Featherstone colours. As Widnes come forward now. Through Lloyd. Brooks. Plenty of involvement for Brooks since coming onto the field. Plays it 40 out from his own line. Field. Field, shaped to give it out wide, keeps hold of it himself, and smothered in the tackle of Addy and Jones. Plays it on halfway, this will be the last one. Lyons just hoists it high, out wide it's taken on the full by Gale. He's got a little bit of real estate to make up now before he finds a Widnes defender and just puts Fozard on his back. And a big carry, brings the crowd to their feet, and a quick play of the ball as well for Aitkins, who leaves the man's behind and almost left his shorts behind. Makes another 5 metres up, 5 metres short of the halfway line. This is very good stuff from Featherstone, full of energy and running early in this second half, as Rhys Butterworth is introduced onto the field by James Ford for his first taste on debut for Featherstone Rovers, and he's straight into the action at dummy half, scampers out of acting half and picks up 8 or 9 metres. It's a double substitution, in fact, for Featherstone. Bussey back on the field as well. It's Tennyson, the man who makes way, and Bussey standing in the tackle, and he's eventually put on his back, 20 metres out. This will be the last one for Featherstone. Comes right. Jones, little bit of a kick through the middle here. Take another bounce by Ince. Ince is knocked off his feet. Does really well there and gets back into the field of play, the Widnes winger. How did he manage to do that? Never say die attitude, as Butt goes forward, and Widnes, in fact, get the penalty. Featherstone straying inside the 10 off that play. Far too quick off the line. And a relieving penalty it is once again, as Gilmore wastes no time in hoofing the ball downfield over that far touchline on the halfway line. So just like that, Widnes, if they can complete their set, we'll imagine we'll have an attacking opportunity down Featherstone's end of the field. Featherstone leading by 22 points to 6, 10 minutes of the second half played. Gilmore gives it to Lyons onto Walker. Walker's put down 30 metres out. Owens runs out of room, eventually submits to the tackle of Day. Featherstone's most recent try scorer, of course. Langtree back in field he comes. Minikin
Locked onto the ball with help from Adi. Kamano was down low to halt his progress. 20 metres out. This is Featherstone Widnes' best attacking opportunity of the second half so far. Lions gives it to Gilmore. Gilmore out wide to Owens. Owens finds the pass to Ince. Ince is going to score in the left corner. And the Featherstone defence can't believe it. There's hands in the air everywhere. That pass looked at flat at best from Jack Owens. Hit Ryan Ince on the chest. And he raced down the left touchline from 15 metres out to score in the corner. And Widnes give themselves a lifeline in this game. It came off the back of a penalty. Featherstone straying offside at the other end of the field. Widnes found touch. They went through the hands. Pulled the trigger on the right to left shift. And Ryan Ince touches down in the corner to cut the deficit to 12 points. With an 11 minutes gone here in the second half of the Millennium Stadium. It's Featherstone Rovers 22, Widnes Vikings 10. There's a few disgruntled fans around the ground here and the Featherstone players. They believe that last pass from Owens was forward. The referee, I believe it's Scott Mikulauskas, wave play on.
1 minute.
And Ince calmly finished it in the corner as Gilmore steps up to add the extra two. And he's put the ball between the posts. Two from two from the Widnes full halfback this afternoon. Cuts the gap to 10 points. It's Featherstone Rovers 22, Widnes Vikings 12. Back we come for the restart. Featherstone be frustrated by that try that they've just conceded. But Featherstone have only found themselves in trouble in this game when they've been ill-disciplined. As the kick restart comes from Max Roberts. He takes it 20 metres away from his own line. Wild. Up to the 40 metre line. Not a lot of distance on that kickoff, funnily enough, from Connor Wynn as Walker hits and spins away from one but goes down eventually in the tackle of Bussey. Lions into the line, flat pass there for Langtree, stands in the tackle. Turner holds on. Day down low. Featherstone are defending inside their own half again here as Fozard slips the net almost. Pulled to ground there with a shirt collar by Danny Addy. And that'll be the last one. Widnes have gone a fair way downfield here. They're going to kick from 20 metres out. Testing kick from Gilmore, taken by Connor Wynn. Does very well. The former Hull FC man pouches it safely. Plays it 10 metres out. England on the blind side. Makes a solid 5 metres after contact there. Widnes man left on the deck. Hall has looked good. Some really nice touches so far, Corey Hall, in this game. He's brought down inside the 20. That's the third tackle for Featherstone. Butterworth hands it on to Gale. Gale bumps away from 1-2. Finds his front. Gareth Gale has earned a quick play of the ball and does so for Butterworth, who scampers out of dummy half now. Gives it to Jones. Jones was belted by the Featherstone man there. Owens in off his edge. Butterworth doing the kicking this time. It's a good kick. Hooks it right back through the middle of the field over the top of Owens' head, who cuts it off 5 metres from his own line and gives it on to Butt. Butt comes across field. Minikin misses his man and it's given back to Owens, who's cut down eventually by Day. Gale did enough to knock him off his feet. End-to-end stuff here at the Millennium Stadium. Featherstone still leading by 22 points to 12. 26 minutes of the game remaining. Butt stiff arm into the face of Kamano, who comes again and hauls him to ground 5 short of halfway. Lions gives it to Kirk now, who's back on the field. Walker, the man who's been taken off. And it's a big carry from Kirk. Best part of 15 metres up and over the 40 metre line of Featherstone side of halfway. Fozard finds the Gilmore, dinks it over the top, takes a bounce on its point again by it. Nice kick, a nice bounce for Aitkins. He beats his first man and is wrapped up eventually by Wild. Hall now. Another carry through the middle of the field. Corey Hall is scragged to the ground by Kirk. Featherstone fans thought that the Widnes were offside there as Wynn across field, bumps away from Lyons, and he's brought down by Fozard, who comes again with a second effort, but not penalised by the referee, as Brooks, Minikin beats 1-2 up and over the 40 metre line. A few hands in the tackles here from Widnes at the moment, just trying to slow Featherston down as Bussey up and over the halfway line now. Last tackle, they're going to kick from halfway. Jones playing acting half now. Puts it into the air. It's taken by Ince under pressure from Hall and beats him. And almost gets around his man again. As some very brave pieces of play from Ryan Ince in the second half so far. Featherston certainly targeting him with the kicks and has been up to the task after that first error he made in the first few minutes of the second period, as Roberts plays it, looping pass infield for Owens. Owens gives it to Butt. Butt being busy off his wing. Put ground 20 metres out by Turner. Come forward again through Lloyd. Lloyd, refusing to go down here, will eventually play it. 35 out. Fozard gives it to Gilmore. He's going to kick early here. Wynn's going to have to show some speed to get back to this kick. He's looking for the 40-20. It's cut off in the end by the winger, who loops the ball back in field for Aikins. Aikins dangerous with his footwork going across field. Gives it to Gale. Gale trying to straighten things up here. Bit of fleet of foot from Gareth Gale, and he's put down 20 metres out. Ball been in play for a long time here. There's really sort of end-to-end action. It's Butterworth. Goes quickly, gives it to Day. Day into the tackle there of field. The 40-metre line now. Featherston's half. Butterworth shapes to give it one way. Gives it short side to Turner. Turner out to Gale. Gale's put into touch there by Butt. And just overcooking the play a little bit, Featherston there, it has to be said. See what they were trying to do, just shifting the ball out wide to Gale, but there was no chance that Gale was going to get on the outside of his man there. There was no room to work in, and the big winger just putting a foot on the touchline. He tried to keep the ball in play, but to no avail, and Widnes will get the turnover. 10 metres short of halfway, inside their own half. It was the last tackle, so it will be a turnover. Rules the referee. Just a simple play of the ball. Score remains 22 points to 12 in Featherston's favour. They've had 18 minutes of the second half gone. Kirk is cut down in a good tackle there. I believe that since Butterworth came onto the field, it's actually Harry Bowes that's the man that's come from the field. Jones operating in the halves alongside Turner, with Butterworth now playing at nine. That's Field refusing to go on the ground, eventually put to ground by Butterworth, 5 metres into Featherston's half. Fozard hit with a good strong shot there from Bussey, who comes again to throw him to ground. 35 metres away from the Featherston line. Widnes with tackles in the bag. Kirk, ball out wide, taken by Lyons. Dumps it back off to Langtree. Langtree through the middle of the ruck. Langtree's one-on-one. He passes the ball over the top to Owens. And Owens scores underneath the posts. Back-to-back tries for the Widnes Vikings. That try came from nothing, really, it had to be said. It was just a simple drop-off play for Langtree, who just ran into acres of space in the middle of the ruck, and he popped the ball back on the inside, knowing that Owens would be there in support. Owens touches down underneath the post, and with the conversion attempt from Bang in front, we suddenly have a one-score game. It's Featherston Rovers 22, Widnes Vikings 16. You'd imagine here with Tom Gilmore kicking from bang in front of the post here, we'll soon have a 4-point game on our hands going into the final quarter. Set to be a nervy final quarter of this game. Featherston had the game under control, by no means relinquishing the lead just yet, but Widnes getting back-to-back tries, and Featherston just getting a little bit sloppy through the middle of the ruck as Gilmore pilots the ball between the sticks. We do have a 4-point ball game now. It's now Featherston Rovers 22, Widnes Vikings 18. Featherston needing to lift here a little bit as the crowd cheering them on. Slow walk up to halfway here. No panic needed here from Featherstone. Still have the lead here, just need to manage the game. As the kickoff comes from Wynn, taken by Butt. Butt is wrapped up there by Day and Addy. Plays it 20 out. Brooks. Brooks stands in the tackle. And he'll play it 30 metres away from his own line. Gilmore, shaped to go inside, gives it outside to Owens. Owens gives it on to Wild. Wild takes a couple of defenders with him up and over the 40 metre line. Kirk has hit a strong shot by Butterworth, but came again Kirk and up and over that halfway line. Flat pass there for Field, too much room around the ruck there for Featherstone's liking. He's made 20 metres on that play, Callum Field, and he'll play it 30 metres out from the line now. Gilmore puts it high under a little bit of pressure. Akins takes it cleanly, takes it really well in fact there, under pressure from Max Roberts. And Corey Hall now looking to clear his line up to the 20. As Featherstone come forward again, Gale bumps away from one. Such a strong ball carrier, Gareth Gale. Plays it 30 metres from his own line. Butterworth flat pass there for Minikin. Minikin has a little bit of room, but plays it now for Butterworth. Tanner, flat pass there for England. England slips the net. England, and he's just ankle tap knocked off his feet. The pass comes to Tanner and it's knocked down by Gilmore. And it's given as a witness balls of Featherstone. Also close to manufacturing a half break, and Advivac turned the ball over, and it's those fine margins we're talking about again. The last few sets, Featherstone haven't got to the end of their sets. And witness back through Callum Field here on the second tackle into Featherstone territory. 4 points. It's the difference. Featherstone 22, Widnes Vikings 18. You're listening live on FRTV as Lyons comes wide for Owens. Owens gives the ball for Butt. Butt cuts in field. It's wrapped up by Turner. Ball and all tackle there from the Featherstone halfback. Had to be as well. 30 metres out. Owens gives it to Brooks. Brooks to Fozard. Wasn't quite expecting it. Just has to take the tackle himself and is put to the ground there. 20 metres away from the line. Still tackles remaining for Widnes. Centre of the field, Owens through the middle of the ruck, gives it to Kirk. Good tackle, knocked off his feet. Ball and all from Brad Day. That'll be the last one for the visitors. Big defensive play coming up for Featherstone. Lyons gives it out to Gilmore. Gilmore infield for Owens. Good tackle again from Turner. Two really big pieces of play defensively from the big Featherstone halfback. Just trapping the man. Ball and all, putting him on the ground. And the turnover there. Featherstone clearing their line through Gale. Knocked off his feet there by Langtree. Hall comes forward. He goes down 15 away from his own line. Widnes very much in the ascendancy here in terms of the momentum in this game. Featherstone needs something. They might get it through Connor Wynn here, who bumps away from one and two and eventually put on the ground by Langtree, and he's lost the ball there, and it's given us a knock on. And things going in Widnes's favour here as Connor Wynn, such a strong ball carrier, but he does have one or two of those errors in him. Just knocks the ball on in his own 20, and all of a sudden Widnes have the field position. And they can smell blood in the water here, Featherstone. That's three or four sets in a row. They haven't got to the end of their set here, and really inviting Widnes down their end. And a big defensive set needed from James Ford's men here. 4 point lead they have. 16 minutes of the game remaining. The scrum is won. Gilmore gives it out. The pass out wide to Ince. Ince is going to try and go on the outside of his man. That's a great piece of play from England. Just haired across the field. Cut him off. And brings him down 10 metres out. Roberts now. Drives it forward and he's driven back. With Butterworth there. Addy in there to help out underneath. Put back to the 10 metre mark. Field. Just trying to bullock his way through the middle and trying to get his arm free. Eventually thrown to the ground there by Tanner. Gilmore. Pass out the back. An untidy one picked up by Ince. This is sometimes dangerous. Another untidy pass. He's dropped on by Lyons there, who did very well to salvage possession, and he's knocked the ball on, in fact. Some real high fives. That's a big win for Featherstone defensively. Really attacked with their defence there, forcing an error from Widnes. And it was Lyons who just dived on the ball and just rolled over, bobbled it there. And that'll be a turnover for Featherstone. And a chance to work the ball down the other end of the field. It feels like an eternity since we saw any action down the other end. It's been all Widnes in the last 10 minutes of this game. Back-to-back tries have brought them back into this, but Featherstone still holding on to that four-point advantage. Gale off the scrum win. Goes down 30 metres away. Butterworth. Minikin. Never willing runner, really hard worker. This afternoon, Greg Minikin plays it 35 away from his own line. Addy straightens things up. Good carry from Danny Addy. Five short of halfway comes the Featherstone skipper, and he's lost the ball there, Danny Addy. And Featherstone just cannot get through a set, quite simply, at the moment. And it was such a good carry from Danny Addy, but just as he hit the ground, the ball was just dislodged there. Really, really frustrating if you're a Featherstone player here. It's James Ford, we can see on the touchline, he's come down to the touchline below. He's not happy with what he's seeing from his players in the last few sets of six. As Owens gives it on now to Lloyd. Lloyd is put to ground in the tackle of Minikin. 40 metres away from the Featherstone line. Owens, good run. Out of the line there came Butterworth, but Langtree finds an offload to Kirk. It's given to Johnston, who's back on the field now. Strong shot from Murray, who rides the tackle there of Tanner. As they come forward again, Johnston takes the pass from Gilmore. He's tackled 20 metres away from the line now. Centre field, they come. Murray out to Lyons. Lyons dummies, tries to slip the net himself. Good tackle on the inside, and it had to be from Danny Addy. Closes the door, 10 metres out, just to the right-hand side of the post. Centre field, they come now through Kirk. Kirk is put to ground, 8 metres out. This will be the last one. Huge play coming up. As the kick comes through from Fozard, it's bobbled and picked up all over the place. And Fozard trying to get to the line, he regathered it himself. And that's a wonderful, wonderful defensive play from Caleb Aitkins, who manages to wrap the ball up. And that will be the turnover. Will it? He's not. He's given... I'm sure that was the last tackle. The referee signaled the last tackle. Well, there's a little bit of confusion here. It must have given that a Featherstone player played at the ball here. So it looks like it's another set of six to Widnes here. 10 metres out. Gilmore gives it out to Owens. Owens, ball manufactured out wide to Ince. Ince is going to score in the corner. And locks up the scores here at the Millennium Stadium. A little bit of controversy, or certainly confusion, from the referee there. I mean, it was the last tackle. Fozard dinked the kick through. He managed to get the ball back and was wrapped up over the try line. But he must have signalled. He never actually signalled it, but must have given the decision that a Featherstone player had played at the man. That's the only played at the ball. That's the only thing I can think, because Widnes went through a couple of players there before they pulled the trigger on the player. The ball out wide to Ryan Ince again. Smuggled the ball out. Owens getting the quick play out wide. And Ryan Ince dives in for his second try of the game. And with 11 half minutes to go here, it's 22 points apiece with a kick to come for the visitors. Gilmore now with a really, really difficult conversion. He's 3 from 3 so far this afternoon. But this, arguably his toughest one, to try and give Widnes the lead for the first time in this game. And he's pulled it through the middle of the posts as the flags go up, and Widnes do have the first lead of the game. It's now Featherstone Rovers 22, Widnes Vikings 24.
And Featherstone, having been in total control of this game after a few minutes of the second half, find themselves behind. What have they got in response here for the dominance that has been firmly in Widnes's favour in the last quarter of an hour of this game, in which they've scored three tries to take an unlikely two-point lead heading into the final 10 minutes of this game. Widnes play it here through Kirk Johnston. Gives it to Murray. Murray just trundling it forward here. Takes a couple of Featherstone defenders with him. Langtree. Still going, Danny Langtree. Held up in the tackle and wrestled to the ground there by Butterworth, but not before he's advanced the ball 5 metres into Featherstone's half. Johnston is taken there by Tanner. Cries for a high tackle, not given by the referee. This will be the last one. Widnes kicking from 40 out. Taken by Wynn there. Not the best kick from Widnes. And Connor Wynn now will retain possession 30 metres away from his own try line. What have Featherstone got here in the final 9 minutes of this contest? Trailing by 2 points now. This is where they need to show some character and work themselves back into this contest, which they've led for such a long period of the game. Butterworth gives it to Akins. Akins up and over halfway. It's a good run from Caleb Akins. Still going, the fullback, up to the 40-metre line, Widnes's side of halfway. Butterworth to Jones. Jones almost slipped through himself there. Connor Jones. Butterworth to Addy. Short ball there for Bussey. Bussey looked to get his arm free but couldn't do so. He's dragged to the ground. It's a last tackle. Butterworth puts it into the goal area. It's taken by Lyons. Lyons isn't going to escape the pressure there. And the goal line dropout coming up for Featherstone. Really, really good piece of play there from Butterworth. Didn't really know what to do with it at first, but just a really well, delicately placed kick onto the toe, into the in-goal area. Lyons trapped it for Widnes, but there was no chance of him getting out of the field of play, or getting out of the in-goal rather, and he was taken over the dead ball line. And this is a goal line dropout coming up for Featherstone, and the first bit of real territory Featherstone have had for the best part of 20 minutes of this game, as the dropout is taken, given on to Tanner now. Tanner careers back into the Widnes defence, and he'll play the ball 25 out. This is a huge set coming up for Featherstone in the context of this game. 7.5 minutes to go at the Millennium Stadium. It's 22 points to 24 as Day goes down 10 metres out. Butterworth, looping pass infield for Bussey. Bussey finds Jones. Pulls the trigger on the ball. He's going to find Wynn outside. And Wynn's going to score and restores the lead for Featherstone Rovers. A wonderful pass from Connor Jones, playing out of position in the half-back role. He got the ball. He didn't quite know what to do with it. He saw that the Widnes defence had come right up and in, and he fired the perfect pass onto the chest of Connor Wynn, who raced around and improves the angle and puts Featherstone back in the lead. It's now Featherstone Rovers 26, Widnes Vikings 24. We are set for a grandstand finish here at the Millennium Stadium. 6 minutes to go, we've got on the clock. And Featherstone, having gone behind to that second Ryan Ince converted try just a few minutes ago, have hauled themselves back in front in this game. Wonderful, wonderful play from Connor Jones. As I say, shifted to the halfback role in this second half, playing out of position. The ball came out to him out the back. He had options that seemed to be covered, and at this last minute, double pumped, fired the perfect pass, a 15 metre cutout pass over the top of Ince's head, who'd raced in off his wing onto the chest of Connor Wynn, who scores out wide to put Featherstone back in front by the slenderest of 2 point margins. Danny Addy with the conversion attempt. It's going to be about
8 metres in from the right touchline. It's a tough one. Danny Addy, 3 from 4 so far this afternoon, deputising the kicking role. Steadies himself. 20 metres out, the Featherstone skipper. Steps up to take the extra 2. And the crowd will tell you that it's gone between the posts. And Featherstone have a 4-point advantage now inside the final 5 minutes of the Millennium Stadium. It's Featherstone Rovers 28, Widnes Vikings 24. What a second half this has turned into for the neutral fan. If you're a Featherstone fan, it's real heart in mouth stuff now, as they've got themselves back into the lead as Owens goes for the long kickoff, taken by Hall. Hall now taken down 20 metres away from his own line. Butterworth played a big role in that, setting up that try, got them the repeat set, gives it to Turner, who gives it to Day. Day grasped in the tackle of Lyons. Bussey, who's been enormous for Featherstone in the middle, up to the 40. Butterworth, Addy, flat pass for Tanner. Tanner just takes that carry just short of the halfway line. He's held, gives it to Addy now. Addy just takes the ball about 8 metres into Widnes's half. This will be the last one. Just need to get to the kick here. Jones puts it high, looking to put Ince under a little bit of pressure here. He takes it well, and there's a wall of white shirts in front of him. And he's beaten, almost beaten the tackle there, Ryan Ince. And he eventually put on the ground. And it's a good job that England managed to get the second effort in the tackle there, otherwise Ince was away. But his wing partner, wrapped up in the tackle of Day, 30 metres away from his line now. Lloyd, held in the middle of the field. Inside the final 3 minutes as we see it. That's not an official timekeeper's clock there, but with scoreboard timer says inside the final 3 minutes. Johnston comes wide to Lyons. Lyons out to Owens. Owens gives it to Lloyd, gives it to Butt. Butt in field. Good tackle again from Turner. With Featherstone defending for their lives here, leading by 28 points to 24. You're listening live on FRTV. Last tackle. Gilmore's knocked off his feet and loses the ball. That's a great piece of defensive play from Reece Butterworth. And what a 5 minutes the youngster on dual registration from Hull KR has had. A real impact on this game with and without the ball, as he just brought down the Widnes scrum half, ball and all on the last tackle, and that will be the turnover, 40 metres away from the Featherstone line. And Featherstone take another step towards victory here, as Hall, first carry, coming forward, Corey Hall, great yards after contact there, he'll play it on halfway. Butterworth gives it to Gale now. Gale, as James Ford makes another change in the final minutes of this one. Kamano back into the action for Tanner. Minikin's brought down, 40 out. Butterworth, shaped to go right, comes left and goes himself, and he's eventually put on the ground by Callum Field. Addy drops off Kamano, fresh legs from Kamano through the middle of the field, and he'll take another 10 metres after contact there, Maurice Kamano. That'll be the last one for Featherstone, 20 metres out, big play needed here. Jones, the kicker comes into the path of Connor Wynn. Connor Wynn's got it off a deflection, and Connor Wynn will score and seal the game for Featherstone Rovers. The kick came from Connor Jones. It deflected off a witness man into the path of Hall, who just tipped it on for Connor Wynn, who gets his second try in quick succession. And Featherstone, they look down and out 5 minutes ago after Widnes had taken the lead, but they've hit back in fine fashion and shown some character here to get 2 tries in the final 5 minutes of this, and they now lead the Widnes Vikings by 32 points to 24.
Connor Jones having involvement again there. His kick came forward, he didn't get it quite as he'd liked. A little bit of an untidy one, it ricocheted off a witness man into the arms of Corey Hall, who is incidentally limping in back play here. We certainly hope that's nothing serious. But the skill and the awareness to be able to just tip that ball on back out to Connor Wynn, who strolled in a similar fashion to his first try a few minutes ago. A quick fire double from Connor Wynn is surely going to get Featherstone home here. As he comes from the field now, Corey Hall, he's definitely picked up some form of injury. He gets a rousing applause here on his way from the field. Harry Burrs will finish the game in the centres, you'd imagine, as Danny Addy, about 3 metres in from the far right touchline. Taking his time, steps up. And he's pulled that across the face of the post. So the scoreline remains the very important 8-point cushion here for Featherstone. They lead Widnes by 32 points to 24. What a second half this has been. Ebbed and flowed, end to end, the highs and lows. Featherstone would have been thinking they were heading for a comfortable win, and then Widnes came roaring back into the game, taking a 2-point advantage. But since then, Featherstone have finished the game strong. Not entirely sure how long is left on the clock. The scoreboard at the time of Connor Wynn scoring said less than a minute. As we know, this clock's not exactly accurate, but there can't be more than a couple of minutes of this game left. Owens puts it down the field again. Still not persisting with the long kickoff here, Widnes. I wonder if that's a sign of how long is left in this game. Have they conceded their first loss of the season? Wynn now takes the carry. If Kamano took the first, Connor Wynn with the second. Slow play the ball here. As you'd imagine, Gale, willing runner again, just backing his way upfield. He's brought down 40 out. Butterworth to Bussey. Made a real impact since coming back onto the field for his second spell, Jack Bussey. Play it five short of halfway. Butterworth for Addy. Addy to Jones. Jones had a stellar game playing in two separate positions. Plays it on halfway. Burrs doing the kicking, just drills it into touch. As the siren sounds in the background, the cheers all around from the majority Featherstone crowd at the Millennium Stadium. The players high five and rejoice as Featherstone come away with a hard fought win. You have to say there's an element of relief there in the context of this game, as Featherstone were in total control just after half time when Brad Day scored to make it a 22 points to 6 advantage before Widnes came roaring back into the game, as I said, with a double for Ryan inside the side of a Jack Owens try, all converted by Tom Gilmore to give Widnes a 2-point lead heading into the final 10 minutes of this game. But we said they needed to find some character, they needed to find some answers. Well, James Fawn's men found it in abundance, getting themselves back into the contest, turning the momentum and converting it into two tries to Connor Wynn, one of them converted by Danny Addy, to seal a remarkable win for Featherstone Rovers. Back-to-back wins for Rovers now, as they elevate their position in the table and had Widnes Vikings their first loss of the championship season. We thought it was going to be an enticing game between these two sides, and it certainly did not disappoint. But in the end, Featherstone Rovers come away victorious, and a hard-fought and well-deserved win it is. The Featherstone fans go home happy. Full time here at the Millennium Stadium. It's finished. Featherstone Rovers 32, Widnes Vikings 24. Thank you very much for listening live on FRTV. Have a very good afternoon.